Ian McElhinney, Sir Barristan Selmy, Game of Thrones. Well, way back when, he was part of the Targaryen setup. He was actually the commander of the King's Guard to Aegon Targaryen. And as a proper commander of the King's Guard, he was dutiful. He did what was expected of him. He was noble. But unfortunately for him, he was serving a mad king. And in the battle that subsequently happened at the Trident, he survived and was actually pardoned by Robert Baratheon and then became Robert Baratheon's commander of the King's Guard. That was fine. He liked Robert. Unfortunately, Robert wasn't. He was a great soldier, but he wasn't a great king. And Robert eventually died and was followed by the Lannisters, who are a despicable bunch, none of whom he liked. And at the point where he was offered retirement, he said, you know, it's not this for a game of soldiers, I'm out of here. And disappeared, and then returned, going back to his original roots, if you like, going back to the Targaryen clan. So he went in search of Daenerys, and now he's with Daenerys and commander of her Queen's Guard. And where he goes from here, we have to yet find out. Well, I feel it's very important to have the odd just character, the odd noble figure in it, which is where Barristan, I think, comes in. I mean, he is a character who I think has been essentially noble throughout, and is one of the few of whom you could actually say that. So from my point of view, characters like him kind of need to survive, or should survive, to keep a sort of a proper balance between good and evil through the whole thing. You need some of your villains to continue, because they provide a kind of a constant tug of excitement through it. So the odd villain will hang in there until the very end, I'm sure. But I would like to think that those who have a bit of nobility about them, or who have grown into nobility, you know, might somehow or another end up sort of completing the circle, if you like. Yeah, I mean, for my character, I think, as I say, that he's important in Daenerys' setup, because, first of all, she respects his age, she respects his knowledge, his history. He knows a lot more about her family than she does, and he's in many ways a source for that, for her. She knows that he will always try and do what he perceives to be the right thing. So I think in that sense he's very important to her. And I like to believe, I can't predict of course, I like to believe for that reason that he will be around to support her for the foreseeable future.